easiest audience would be people who just love opulent, operatic epics, and so senso, and very much so the leopard will be very appealing to people that like big widescreen, immense action movies and deep passions. He never just let it become only about armies and forces of history. He always emphasized the people, particularly families, and what happens to family when in times of difficulty, because he'd come from such an amazing family himself, I think. And then people who love rich set design, antiques and things from the 1800s, the early 1900s. His use of music in film is always very, not just opera, but symphonic. Also, he was really good about choosing actors that were maybe on the cusp of becoming stars. Alain Delon was one, Claudio Cardinale. He could spot the talent very much. And he also would take people who'd been known for a particular kind of acting and certain themes and all that, and put them in something totally different. I think all the characters, they're not always lovable by any means, but they're fascinating people and they're involved in interesting situations. Anybody interested in Italy at different times and how he's representing it, that would definitely be another appeal to audiences. And then people are interested in social change. Certainly Rocco and his brothers, you have the Southerners coming to the North trying to get jobs, but also the end of eras. La Belle Époque, it's when the aristocrats are losing their power. And Visconti has, I think he's of two minds about that, because that's his class, his people. But with his interest in the poor and communism and trying to create equality, he also was very supportive of these changes. So it's not schizophrenic, but it is, he's of two minds about this.